Ugh. It smells like a dead Ninja Turtle down there. Who farted? If we have to go to the bottom of the well, then you're coming with us. Yo, yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I'm RJ. Quick heads up, we're going to have a big live stream later on tonight. Rockstar just released part 2 of the Blood Money update, so you can join us on both Xbox and PlayStation Red Dead Online. Just make sure to sub, hit the notification bell with all notifications on. It'll let you know as soon as we go live later on. We'll be live into the night. Hopefully we'll see you there. So we're going to head to the bottom of the well. During the storyline, you find out that this house, Compson's Stead, has a hidden slave dungeon in the basement. It is extremely messed up. Luckily, it is no longer in use. But considering they do have the dungeon, you can assume that one of the slaves was thrown to the bottom of this well where they stayed for 62 days. I'm going to explain it in today's video. Do me a huge favor. Hit the like button. It really helps out. So the first thing that you'll notice is this board has marks all over it. So either they are whip marks, which is pretty likely, or the board is upside down, therefore trapping the slave into the well, and they were scratch marks of them trying to get out. So we're gonna head to the bottom of the well. You can find a secret message. There's gonna be the number 62, 62 tallies, 3 clouds, and a sun. Now, if you've looked at the Chilliad mystery in Grand Theft Auto 5, you may get some similar vibes. All right, so here it is right there. I'm gonna put it into first person view so you guys can see better. There are the tallies coming out to a grand total of 62. So that might be an important number. It could just be that whoever was trapped down here was tallying each day, making it to 62 days, which is a pretty long time to be trapped in a well. But then you also have the 3 crosses. They're the clouds. No rain coming out of the clouds. It looks like sunny weather with 3 clouds. So most likely Rockstar is telling us what kind of weather we need at a specific location in the game. One of the members of the Trippy fam did hit me up. They found the crosses that look just like this, and it's at a very unlikely location. I thought the crosses represented a grave, much like these two that you can find right here, not too far away from the well. But there's only 2, there's not the 3, and if you look at those crosses from the message, they definitely have a different style than the crosses that you find in graves all around the game. Instead, the crosses could be from a rock carving, something we've definitely seen many times throughout Red Dead Redemption 2. I'm going to meet you up north in the Grizzlies. A longtime member of the Red Dead community, Premiero5, told me to go right here and look towards the mountain to find 3 of the biggest crosses that you will ever find. And here they are. You can see them on the side of the cliff. At first, it may be hard to believe, but they really do look a lot like the ones that we just saw in the well. And it points out a bit of a mysterious location right down here in the tunnel. Okay, so you can find different train tunnels throughout the game, but this one seems to be a little bit different. It seems very unique. You can even find what seems to be doorways in the tunnel. As we slide down, hold on, Arthur. Tuck and roll, tuck and roll. He should be all right. Couple bruises, maybe a concussion. He's fine. It's not his first rodeo. So right here, I'll point it out on the map again in case you guys want to come find it. Maybe our horse will come along as well. But this is where you can find a tunnel directly beneath the hidden crosses. Now, I tried to come during the right weather with the sun out. You know, that light cloud coverage that we saw depicted on the mural in the well. But if you come into the tunnel, notice how there's a bunch of boards everywhere. You can also see what appears to be blocked entrances. Now, it's different color bricks than what you'll find in the rest of the tunnel. It almost seems like this was meant to be a tunnel that you can go inside, and maybe this is some sort of entrance that we can break into. Let's take out the dynamite and find out. It really could be pointing us to this random location up here in the Grizzlies. Hopefully this busts open. It also could be depicting 6:20 with the number 62. It could be 6:20 p.m. So we'll try to break them open right at 6:20. Maybe we can get inside these blocked entrances. Again, the bricks are a different color. If you played Legend of Zelda like me, where you've taken bombs to find hidden entrances, I'm definitely getting some similar vibes right here in the train tunnel. And there's 2 more just like it on the other side. See how when you run in, it's almost like you're going inside, but you're blocked. I think the mural from the bottom of the well is a lot like the Chilliad mural. So at first, you might not think much of the Chilliad mystery mural which you can find hidden at the tallest peak in Grand Theft Auto 5. So this is almost the opposite, where in Red Dead Redemption 2, the mural is found at the lowest point at the bottom of the well. But here you have the weather, all showing off a secret appearance by a UFO that you have to unlock. So again, you might think that the mural at the bottom of the well is something simple, or it could be something a lot more complicated, like the Chilliad mural, pointing us to a bigger secret hidden in the game. Once again, much love to Premier05 for pointing out the location. He might be onto something. There's 62 tallies. It just passed 620. Unfortunately, the wall will not break open. Now, in real life, this wall would definitely break with a dynamite. But here, it's not opening for nothing. But the fact that it does have that different color makes it a little bit suspicious. We kind of phase right through it. Maybe it was meant to be a tunnel, but for now, it is completely closed off. So let me know what y'all think about the three crosses. At the end of the day, if it's not the crosses you can find on the side of the mountain, it has to be three unmarked graves hidden in the game. Here's one more look at the crosses on the side of the mountain. I think during the middle of the day, they stand out even more. So we're going to stop by the well, and I'll show you one last location that I think might be correlating to the mural. Ooh, a lucky quarter. We'll take it. I think when a lot of us saw the crosses, we thought of a grave. But when you see what they look like on the side of the mountain, it could be more than that. It could be showing us an entirely different location altogether, along with the sun, the clouds, telling us the exact type of weather that we need. I've been searching throughout all of Red Dead Redemption 2, looking for three sticked crosses in a row, just like at the bottom of the mural. I found groups of two, groups of four. There are three at Calaga Hall, but there's two more right next to it. And then here at Braithwaite Manor, there is three in a row, but then two more directly behind it. So nothing exactly like the crosses in the mural. Let me know what you think. It could be the rock carvings. It could be other unmarked graves, but it's definitely one of the biggest mysteries in all of Red Dead Redemption 2. We got another big video in the works, so stay tuned. Don't forget to sub if you are new. Also hit the like button. It really helps out. And we'll have a massive live stream later on tonight with the Blood Money Update Part 2 in Red Dead Online. So until then, stay tuned here at Trippy Commentaries, and as always, stay trippy, my friends. Y'all come back now, you hear?